Beyonce responds to Solange's elevator beatdown.
Justin Bieber is being investigated for robbery.
And we have our first look as Ben Affleck as Batman.
Big day on DHR. We've got all of this and more coming up.
Welcome back to the Daily Hollywood Rundown with Misty and Aaron coming at you on Wednesday.
What's up? Yes, it is Wednesday. Yep. Glad that you mentioned that because there is a weird Wednesday coming later in the show.
But first, Aaron has this Justin Bieber update you don't want to miss.
Justin, what are you thinking?
Again.
You keep us employed though, I have to say. Justin Bieber is now being investigated, you guys, for robbery. Yes.
Serious stuff.
This is serious. So this is how it all went down. Justin and his buddies were playing some baseball, doing some mini golf at this little castle mini golf place in Sherman Oaks, California.
Right.
And apparently in the batting cages, Justin had a little tiff with someone in the batting cage.
Shocking.
So a woman and her 13-year-old daughter noticed that it was Justin and noticed that they were fighting, and she pulled out her phone to kind of take a photo of it. Justin saw her and freaked out on her. He ran over, yelled at her, demanded that she give him her phone, and she said, "No way, Jose, I'm not giving you my phone."
Hello, no.
And he went in her purse, went inside of her purse, grabbed her phone, and took it from her, and she's like wrestling with them to get it back, and he steals it. And then he tries to go inside of her phone. Well, of course, it had a password on it. Note to everybody out there, always have a password on your phone.
Yeah.
And he was like, "Tell me what it is, show me the photos." So she's scared of him because he's being aggressive. She shows him that she actually didn't even take a photo of him. He tells her that she should be ashamed of herself in front of her daughter who's 13 years old and clearly
a fan.
So very aggressive. Basically, I mean, I think she could almost sue him for like assault charges because you can't physically touch someone like that. And I don't even know what to think of this.
That's what I'm thinking.
I'm so shocked that his friends, again, would let him get away with this. Where are his friends? Like, stopping him, saying, "Hey, buddy, no, let's not go there. Let's not do that."
I'm torn on this, really, because I understand that you're Justin Bieber. You're sick of people taking photos of you. I get that. But at the same time, it's a free country. Maybe she's a fan. She just wanted to take a picture of you, and you totally overreacted.
Yeah, exactly. So this is all coming from TMZ. I'm sure we'll get more updates on what is actually happening. To be clear, Justin did not get arrested. This whole thing is being investigated.
Yeah.
But that is the woman's side of the story for now. And it just goes to show that Justin doesn't have great influences in his life. I feel like Justin in his heart is a good person, but he has anger. He has anger management issues. He has problems with being under stress.
And he just is put in bad situations and he doesn't handle them well, which is sort of what we've seen with Chris Brown. I hate to bring that up, that comparison.
I know. So we don't know what's gonna happen in this case. We will keep you updated as the craziness develops on this. Speaking of craziness and developments on craziness,
woo!
Misty has the update on the Beyonce, Solange, Jay-Z fight in the elevator. What's up with that?
Yeah, you guys, Beyonce has actually responded to that video, which I'm so shocked by, and she's all about supporting Solange, which is so awesome.
Okay,
so here's the update. People think that the fight actually went down because Solange tried to get two of her friends into the Met Gala by using Jay-Z's name, and he wasn't happy about that. Understandably, I would be mad too. And that Jay-Z tried to go to Rihanna's after party without Beyonce and Solange got mad and was like, "Yo, why do you gotta go after party without your wifey?" Jay-Z didn't end up going to Rihanna's after party, but he totally could have.
Mm-hmm.
So today, if a picture is worth 1,000 words, Beyonce has really given us 5,000 words in response. So she posted 4 pictures of her and Solange on her Instagram. It's not even Thursday, but these are all throwbacks and they're adorable. So the first one is just the girls like kicking up their heels at Coachella. The second one is them hugging in the back of a car. This third one is them smiling at the 2005 NBA All-Star Game. It's adorable.
Mm-hmm.
And then the last one of her and Solange is them hugging on stage when they performed together at Coachella this year. I love that picture.
I do too. Oh, I don't know what to say about this, Misty. I feel like Beyonce is doing damage control right now.
Yeah.
She and Jay-Z have an empire. They have a really big name in Hollywood. They don't want it tainted by any negative drama like this has definitely caused.
Yeah.
I feel like Beyonce is taking the high road and she's trying to do damage control so people will stop talking about the drama.
I like that you brought up the high road because this is definitely a classy way to respond to something like that. And there's one more photo. Like I said, there's 5,000 words here. Then there's another photo of her and Rihanna at the Met Gala because, you know, Rihanna has has been brought into the drama, saying that Jay-Z wanted to go to her party without Beyoncé. Mm-hmm. So Beyoncé is saying right here, you guys, no drama with Rihanna either. Mm. And this all comes after Solange supposedly deleted all the pictures of her and Beyoncé on her Instagram, which, by the way, is not true because I found another one of Beyoncé on her account. So I think that's just all rumors.
Right.
But I love that people are saying that Solange is against Beyoncé, but here Beyoncé is being like, I'm all for Solange. So maybe there's no drama after all. Mm. And there was new rumors today that Jay-Z and Solange were seen jewelry shopping in NYC yesterday, but Mr. Flawless, the jewelry store, is now denying that, so we don't really know what's happening.
Something is fishy about this whole story. Mm-hmm. I'm not sure I believe anything that comes out of this right now.
Yep.
I guess I'll wait to see maybe over the next couple months to see what happens in all of their like careers and the tabloids and see what happens, but I don't believe that everything is as it seems.
Yep, we'll wait and see. Guess what, you guys? Erin, stop that. We're
I'm sorry.
Weird Wednesday time.
My nails needed an update really quickly.
Oh, that's weird.
It's weird.
Guess what we're talking about?
I know what we're talking about, and I'm so excited about it, you guys, because it's Batman, and I love Batman, and we have a brand new photo from director Zack Snyder, who's gonna be directing the upcoming Batman versus Superman movie, of the new bat suit. Ben Affleck is apparently in it. We can't really tell for sure, but you guys.
It looks like he's in there.
The chin kind of gives it away, but before I get into all of this, what do you think about it?
I love the new look. I actually think it's super modern and super sexy, and he's looking more buff than normal, am I right?
Yeah, almost a little too abnormally buff. I don't even know.
I'm okay with that.
Missy's like, if it's fake, it's fine. I don't care, it looks hot. I don't think Ben Affleck is that built. But anyway,
okay.
So he posted this photo, and everybody is buzzing about how sad Batman looks. Why does he look so sad?
That's
he has a cool
weird.
Car, he has a cool costume. Like, what's up with that? So of course, just like usual, we've seen the sad memes of sad Kanye, the ziplining sad Kanye, the sad Keanu Reeves.
Yep, and now sad Batman has been born.
So we're bringing you on Weird Wednesday a couple of our favorite sad Batman photos that have hit the web. Mm-hmm. Starting with this one, this is Batman at Splash Mountain. And he's alone.
At Disneyland. I love this one. This might be my favorite
he's
one.
He's very sad.
I know. But what's sad about Disneyland? It's the happiest place on earth.
But he's there alone and he's riding the ride alone. He's
yeah,
just
I wouldn't want to go there alone. You're
lonely.
Right.
Lonely. Okay, also.
Your favorite one.
My favorite one. Of course, Batman has a really cool Batmobile and we got to see a glimpse of that in the photos as well that hit the web. But this photo is of Batman next to a silver Honda Civic, which is actually what I drive. And he's really sad because.
He's just sad he can't drive the Batmobile. There's nothing wrong with the Honda Civic.
I think it's very smart and affordable. I like my car.
They're
a
safe.
Lot.
They're very safe.
Safe.
I used
reliable.
To have one.
Yes, good cars. Anyway, so he's sad about driving a Honda Civic. No hate on that. That's okay.
No
whatever.
Hate.
Also, this is Batman getting pulled over. He got a speeding ticket.
In the Batmobile.
Very sad.
Normal.
Sad times.
I like this one of a sad Batman at the coffee shop just having some espresso by himself.
Looks like he had a bad breakup or something.
Emo.
Very sad.
Yeah.
My very favorite, drum roll, is Batman with a swing in the rain. Sad.
Yeah, this is amazing.
Everything I could have wanted from a sad Batman.
I
so
know.
That's Weird Wednesday, a little off the beaten path of what we normally cover, but I love Batman and I love sad Batman too. That is it, you guys. Thanks for hanging with us on DHR. But before you go, as always, we want to know, what do you think about the whole Justin Bieber robbery thing? Do you think it should be considered robbery if he went inside of her purse to grab her phone?
Good question, Erin. You guys, thanks so much for hanging out with us on the Daily Hollywood Rundown on this lovely Wednesday with Ersty here. And we'll see you tomorrow. But first, let me take a selfie.
All right, now that that's over, thanks for watching the show today, you guys. But don't leave just yet. We've got more where that came from. Click on the video box right here to get caught up on yesterday's show. And don't forget to subscribe.
Hi-yah!